you're watching this, you're probably considering buying this mini computer. And if you did buy it, I have a few helpful tips to share with you. Stay tuned. It's very surprising that no one is reviewing this powerful little computer. This thing is awesome, and in this video, I'll share with you everything you need to know before buying this computer. We're going to be talking about features, capabilities, and upgrades. This thing feels solid in the hand. I know it probably looks like plastic, but it's actually made out of pure metal. The one I have here is the HP EliteDesk 800 3G Mini 65 Watt. I know, it's ridiculous, but if you remove one word from the name, you'll end up with a different product. Bear with me, we'll get to the part you're waiting for. On the front side and starting from the right, you will see the power button followed by the activity light. And then a universal audio jack with a CTIA headset support and a headphone connector. It's a great option if you're into podcasts. You'll then see two USB 3.0. This one includes one that supports fast charging, a USB Type-C. With the USB Type-C, it's for transferring data and charging other devices only. I have tried to use it as a display port, but unfortunately it does not support that function. In the back, and once again starting from the right, you'll see the power connector, an Ethernet port, four USB ports. Yeah, there's no shortage of ports on this little thing. Here on the right, there's a little lever you can pull to chain or lock the device to a desk. This can be useful in businesses when it's used as an anti-theft feature. Here in the middle, you get an optional port, meaning at the time of purchasing, you can actually choose between three options: an HDMI, a VGA connector like the one I have here, or a USB Type-C. Next to that, there's two DisplayPort connectors. The EliteDesk Mini is capable of connecting up to three different monitors at the same time. And on top, you get a little lock when you want to take the cover off. Now let's open this thing and see what it looks like from the inside. On the back here, you'll see the lock I talked about earlier. Push it to the left and then slide open the case. It's super easy to open. However, the antennas I have here can get in the way. These antennas, by the way, are optional and you can order them separately. One of the things I love about this thing is the lack of screws. You don't need to remove a single screw to get an access to your RAM or SSD. Before we talk about upgrades, I want to point out that the only thing that's not upgradable in this device is the graphics card. It's integrated into the device. You can access the RAM by lifting the cooling fan. Underneath it, you will see two RAM slots. This generation that I have here, which is the 7th generation, can support up to 32GB of DDR4 RAM. I spoke to HP earlier and they said that the speed is maxed out at 2400MHz. However, this computer was released in early 2018. This means it was released at a time when the speed of the memory was a lot slower than it is today. As per Crucial.com, which is a very famous British memory manufacturer, this computer can support up to 3200MHz. Sometimes when dealing with computers, you have to experiment by yourself. A lot of times the manufacturer will state a safe speed and upgrades to protect you from damaging your computer. However, this doesn't mean that the computer itself does not support these speeds and upgrades. The fan is very quiet. You can barely tell whether it's on or not, even if you're right next to it. Here you can see the built-in speaker I told you about earlier. It is super handy to have a speaker built into your computer. It's not crisp or loud, but it's enough to give you basic notifications. Super helpful, by the way. Now let's move on and talk about the SSD. The one I have here is actually an HDD, which is a hard disk drive. I do recommend, actually, if you're going to make any upgrades, that you start with your HDD. It's one of the safest, quickest, and easiest way to boost up the performance of your computer. And it'll give you far better results than actually upgrading your RAM. I have purchased a new SSD from Samsung, which is one of the fastest SSDs you can get right now. The one I have here is the 860 Pro, 256 GB. I won't be showing you the installation of the SSD as it's relatively simple, and there's a lot of videos out on YouTube that shows you how to do it. I have 16 GB of memory in this computer, so I'm not planning on updating it anytime soon. This video was shot in 4K and was actually edited on the computer itself, so 16 GB is plenty of memory for me. I am planning, however, to upgrade the processor sometime soon. As of now, it functions just fine. It's an i7-7700 processor, so that's probably why. HP did say that this computer does not support the i9 processor, but I will be experimenting with it soon. I am super happy with the performance of this computer. Despite the small size, it works and functions exactly like a full desktop PC. Now, if you think my hands are too big, here it is next to a Samsung Note 8. Thank you for watching.